IVM.
On this episode of Paisa, Vaisa, I speak with Ashdin Doctor, the habit coach, about five New Year resolutions for 2019 that are going to help you make smarter and better decisions with your money in the New Year. Stay tuned for that.
Hello, hello, hello. Welcome to another awesome week on the IVM Podcast Network. If you're not following us on social media, please make sure that you do. We're IVM Podcasts on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. We had a Christmas party in the office last week, and you can see pictures of that on our Instagram this week. So please do make sure that you do check it out. On the scene and the unseen, Amit has world-famous author and psychologist Steven Pinker as his guest. Yes, that's right, Steven Pinker. They discuss the state of the world today and how it compares to previous generations. On Geek Fruit, Tejas and Dinkar review Aquaman and tell you their top three scenes from the DC Universe. That's going to be fun. This week on The Habit Coach, Ashdin talks about how listening to podcasts helps you grapple with interesting ideas and thought processes. On Crocktails, Anand narrates the story of Shrikant who falls in love with triplet sisters. Don't miss out on the climax. There's an interesting plot twist at the end. On Vartha Lab, Naveen and Akash talk to the creators of card game Cards Against Sanskar, Adrita Das and Karan Vora. This week on the Pragati Podcast, Pawan discusses how India is increasing access to finance and microfinance for all its citizens. This week on Football Twaddle, the boys discuss the Mourinho sacking and the return of old Gunnar Solskjaer. And guys, it's been a great 2018 and we hope you enjoyed your journey with IVM. We're looking forward to bigger and better things in 2019. Please do tell a friend about the podcast that you've enjoyed. Try and spread the word. That's very important for us. And with that, let's continue on with your show.
Folks, welcome to the Paisa Vaisa year-end special. I'm your host, Anupam Gupta, B50 on Twitter. My guest for this year-end special is Ashdin Doctor, who runs the Habit Coach podcast. We're going to have five New Year resolutions for the New Year 2019, which starts tomorrow, by the way, to help you manage your money better. Ashdin, welcome to Paisa Vaisa. Let's get into this thing about money, okay? What is the deal with people being shy talking about money and, you know, how does that work? What's the deal out here?
Thank you for letting me come onto your podcast. It's a fantastic opportunity to discuss money, especially since whenever you talk about money to people, there's always this little hesitation about starting, about chatting. And many people don't have money as part of their dining table conversation. Mm. People don't tell their family how much they earn. Some people thought like that, and money is always seen as something that is evil. And, you know, if you have lots of money, that is not something that's good. And I think it's important for us to break out of that and get into the habit of actually talking about money. Because money is, in fact, like air. We need it for whatever we do. So there are tiny habits that we're going to discuss today that can help in getting you out of debt, help you save more, and help you get more money.
Talking about habits, you run the Habit Coach podcast. Tell us something about yourself as an introduction to Paisa Paisa listeners.
Okay, fantastic. So I'm a habit coach. And what is a habit coach? The idea is that we constantly try and rely on motivation. You know, I need to, for example, for finance, save so much money. Now, how are you going to save that? The only way to do it is to break it up into tiny, small things that can happen almost without thought. And that's what I call a habit. So can you do something regularly that is small, that won't make a big difference to your life, but will compound over time into something much bigger? And that's what I call a habit. And that's how we think about getting habits into our lives.
And what kind of episodes have you had so far? What kind of good habits can people listen to when they go over and listen to the Habit Coach podcast?
So we talk about habits and with regards to movement, getting movement into your life, things about nutrition, how to get better sleep, how to get more energy during the day, how to conquer your fears. So a lot of fascinating things like that.
And today, it's going to be how to make better personal finance decisions in the new year 2019. Let us start with resolution number one. Okay, really important area all of us struggle with. Okay, Ashdin, how do I save more?
This is a fantastic one because you cannot have money if you don't save it. Right? People keep thinking that you need to spend money to make money. While that is not necessarily true, you need to invest money. But the first part starts with saving. And as Warren Buffett says, don't save what is left after spending, spend what is left after saving. And that's very important because what we end up doing is we spend up all our ghar ka kharcha and then whatever is left at the end, that's what we save. But instead, there's a fantastic thought around this 10% rule. And this is something I picked up from this book called The Richest Man in Babylon, where he said that the first thing you do whenever you get paid for anything, you take 10% and put it aside. You never touch that 10%. So even if you have holidays that are coming up, you don't use that 10% for that holiday. You have a separate fund for your holidays. This is what you save for your life. And that 10% is fantastic because that is your own earnings. Otherwise, what do we typically do? We get our salary, then we pay the dhobi wala, we pay our driver, we pay this person, we pay that person. So who are we typically earning for? We're earning for all these people. Might as well spend, might as well earn for ourselves.
Always 10%. That's a good habit to form. And you just do that without thinking, right? You just make a rule. And that rule is non-negotiable, completely.
Non-negotiable, separate bank account.
Separate bank account. For that, 10% of your income flat every month, month after month, what? For the rest of your life?
For the rest of your life goes there. And as your income increases, the 10% increases.
That's fantastic, folks. So there's your first resolution. How do I save more? Start with 10%. See how that works. Maybe you can boost it as you go along, maybe 20% if you're comfortable with it.
Absolutely.
The more you save today, the better it is for you tomorrow. Second resolution, Ashdin, how do I invest better?
So taking this thought about what do I do with the money that I've just saved, you don't keep it in the bank because you're earning almost nothing from it. The idea is to use that investment and have it grow. So out here, let's talk about something known as compounding. What is compounding? Compounding is a fascinating thought where each time you start investing your money, there's a certain percentage that you've earned. That percent plus the principal amount that you've put in increases for the next month. So we were just doing a simple calculation. And for example, if you had a newborn baby, every month of the year, if you put 1,000 rupees in the new child's bank account, by the time he was 30, you would have put about 3,60,000 rupees in.
12,000 a year multiplied by 30, 3,60,000, simple.
And at a modest percentage of probably 8%, do you know how much you would end up with?
How much?
To 14 lakhs.
That's just compounding.
Wow. So just 1,000 rupees that would have gone, that you would have probably spent on one dinner every month towards your child's future, 14 lakhs, that's insane.
That is insane. Add that, guys. First, you strictly leave apart a certain percentage of your savings. Resolution number one, do not touch it. And then you can go and invest it. We'll give you whatever return. We just took a number of 8%. The beauty is compounding kicks in because it gives you returns over returns. Okay, that's how compounding works. Ashdin, resolution number three, help me to spend smarter. We've covered saving, we've covered investing. People also want to spend. They also have a life. They said, let me live it up a bit, you know. So how do I spend smarter?
I, in fact, got this question the other day when I told somebody about this 10%. And they said, Magar, savings that you just keep it there, you don't spend anything? I was like, no, you spend what is left in the money, right? And people just go completely bananas with the spending, especially because we're in a spending economy. Did you know that this sneaker was on sale by 50%? So I had to buy it.
Of course.
Why did you have to buy it? Yep. How many sneakers do you have? I have 4. But then why did you buy this one? Nay, 50% bachat tha. Is it really a bachat if you ended up spending something that you didn't need? So the idea is to see what value you got from your money. Right. And a habit that I like to follow is every time I spend money on something, I always think back and introspect, did I need it? Did I get the value out of it? What was it like? What could I have spent that money on elsewhere? So in fact, again, Warren Buffett has this quote that says that every time you think of buying a coffee, think about you could have bought a share with that same amount of money, right? Probably not 60 rupees here, but like, so the idea is think about what you could have done with that money instead of constantly blowing it. And when you think about spending, are you thinking of spending in terms of that? Like, for example, if you buy a car. Now that car, the compounding cost is going to be of petrol, of maintenance, etc. You're not going to get anything from it. And we constantly have these discussions with people saying, nay, but a car is an investment. And you say, how can a car be an investment? There's no way a car is an investment. You can say, car is an asset. How is a car an asset? Technically, in your books, it might be. But in your life, is it an asset or is it a liability?
And of course, there is one way to spend smarter. I think Ashdin was also telling us about how he had done a trip. You've done a trip recently where you didn't pay anything, or you did, you know, you're just so smart. You use your credit card reward points. How
did
that work?
So I have this HDFC card that gives my credit card's points into miles. And I had a trip to Dubai the other day where I think I spent a total of, 6,000 rupees, probably much lesser than the entire cost of flying to Dubai. And I stayed with friends, so I didn't have to spend any money on hotels. It was a cheap trip on a weekend and was completely fantastic. So you can use your credit cards to get points that you can spend on without actually using money physically.
Spend smart, folks, okay? Look at your credit card, look at the deals, look at the offers that it has got. We had done a podcast on this with Ajay Autani of Life from a Lounge. You might want to listen to that podcast, and you know, you can get a lot of tips out there of how you can actually use the reward points and the deals and the offers on your credit card to spend smarter, okay? Resolution number four. Actually, this is for young people, you know, who've just started their very first job. They're new with money. They're not really sure. We've told them in the first resolution that you should, as a rule, simply set aside a minimum of 10% of their salaries for saving. We've told them about how to invest better. We've told them about how to spend better. What do you think about a basic, you know, really, really, really basic financial plan for starters, for these people who've just started their first jobs, earning their first salaries? Tell us something about that.
So the first thing is to have a good relationship with money. When you look at your bank balance, how do you feel?
Broke.
Exactly. That's the problem. You never look at your bank balance and feel happy. Right? We're constantly looking at our bank balance saying, if only I had more money, if only I had more money. But how are you going to get more money? You're not going to get it by going out and drinking every night, for example. That's spending money. Mm. In fact, I was reading a very interesting quote that said that if you're not earning the kind of money that you want, you don't have a salary problem, you have a skill problem. Probably go and try and learn a new skill so you increase your money or your income. The next step is definitely do that 10% rule. Put 10% away, start investing it, start getting good advice on where to invest it. One of the best places, of course, is this podcast.
Thank you so much.
And I like another way of approaching it. Have you read Tony Robbins' new book, Unshakable?
Not yet.
Where he discusses one of the best ways of thinking about long-term finances is to put things in low-cost index funds. Mm. Where he says that you just put it, don't think about it, on an SIP basis. So every month your money goes there. Whether the markets go up, markets go down, your money is continuously going in. You don't try to time the market. You don't do anything. And over 30 years, 40 years, you will actually outrun or beat most of the people who are constantly investing and trying to change.
Okay. And I just like to add in, folks out there, that you might want to look at an emergency fund, a little bit, you know, maybe 3 months of your salary, set it aside into maybe a liquid fund or an FD or something. Always take medical insurance, always take life insurance. Okay, we've done a lot of these. We've done a lot of episodes on basic financial planning on Paisa Vaisa. Look up our episode list on the IBM podcast site.
In fact, one of the things I wanted to talk to you about was this, the life insurance. Mm. When do most people take life insurance? After they get married.
Oh, is that so?
So we've done tons of research on this. Huh. And once you get married, the wife says, but life insurance nahi hai? And that's when people start taking life insurance. Imagine if you started taking it much earlier.
Yeah, yeah.
Right? You could put your parents as the nominees.
Yeah.
And it does make a difference.
You should do that. In fact, that's very good. I would say, you know, I think that should be a priority for anyone who's starting off their first job. My guess is the company might already have an insurance policy for you, but you should also pay your own premium. And maybe look at increasing the value every year as, you know, your income goes up. And finally, resolution number five, very special resolution. It's in the true spirit of the festival season. Ashdin, help me give away. Help me donate.
So every time you look at your money and you feel, I don't have enough. Imagine if you took some of that money and actually gave it to somebody who would appreciate that 1,000 or 2,000 rupees. Because for us, sometimes it's, oh, we went out for dinner and spent that much money. But donating money actually gives us a better sense of worth, right? And we're talking about value here. So money is useless without the concept of value. What are you spending it for? And the joy you get out of giving, you make yourself feel better and you make that money work better for you. So the season of giving is here with Christmas, etc. How about starting a fund where you just give and donate every month? The amount of goodwill that you get from that is another form of asset altogether.
form of return, so to say.
Form of return as
and
well.
And guess what, guys? You can also donate your credit card points to Worthy Cause. You know, you should look up that on the internet. Well, folks, that is a wrap on our year-end special, the Paisa Vaisa resolutions for 2019. And wishing all our listeners, Ashdin, wishing you and your listeners in the entire IVM podcast team, me, all of us, wishing you a very, 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 very happy new year. And really hope that you can make smarter, better decisions in your financial life in 2019. Thank you for listening.
Thank you.
Family businesses get a bad rap. At one time, they were looked down on for getting rich, for being too ambitious. Today, they're still looked down on, but for not being ambitious enough. Not agile enough, not modern enough, too traditional in their mindset. The biggest brands and business houses in the country started out as humble family businesses. It's the way India has done business. Join Sonu Basin in conversation with stalwarts of Indian family businesses on the Inheritors podcast series by Bloomberg Quint. Discuss the highs and lows, the needs and pressure points of building a business legacy that spans generations.
Give me a word. Or any line. Kuch bhi ho sakta hai, yaar. Kya kaha aapne? Topi. Okay. Mohan Joshi hated wearing topis. He felt suffocated in them. Topi pehente hi usse school ki yaad aati thi. Where of course he had no choice but to wear a topi. But jis din pass out hua, usi din usne apne topi ka bonfire bana diya. And since then, he'd never worn a cap or a hat. Na kadakti dhoop mein and not even to bacho from the thandi. But from Monday 26th February, Mohan Joshi had to wear a topi. All the time. Why? Because if he didn't, everyone around him knew exactly wo kya soch raha tha. They knew that he was wondering how the girl in the yellow churidar would look bina kapde ke. They knew when he was calling the boss a sadela tomato. They knew everything. Par ye sab hua kaise? Are bhai, yahi to story hai. Aur ye story aap hi ne mujhe diya by giving me the starting word. Yahi to hai, the croc's tales. Words aapke, kahani aapke liye. Catch the stories on Monday and Thursday on the IVM website, app, and anywhere you get your podcast from. See you soon.